So in workflows, we were able to say, whenever an entry is created or whatever, mm-hmm. we're not doing that here, and that's because we're manually hitting the submit for approval button.
Exactly.
Okay. Okay, so select approver using the options below. Who should this approval request be assigned to?
So this, again, is something that would be a lot more dynamic if we had a lot of users in our organization that had roles.
Okay.
You could assign it specifically based off of their role hierarchy in the company, uh-huh. because maybe you want certain managers to approve it.
So that would be the hierarchy field, I assume?
Yep. Or you could, you know, choose that approver manually, mm-hmm. assign it to a queue. In this case, we're just going to automatically assign it to ourselves since okay. we're the only user that could approve anyway.
So what does that mean? Who should I?
Automatically assign approvers. And then just choose yourself.
Safe?
And safe. So I just want to call out that that's really not the most realistic as far as, you know, we would always be the approver. The real dynamic, you know, power behind approval processes is that you could get anyone that needs to approve it based off of their role
or position in the company, yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, so this is explaining how you're going to build out the approval process. So this is another one of those setup windows that if I weren't here right now, this is how you'd teach yourself how to do it.
Sure.
But let's just go to the approval process detail page.